Yeah, five.
So instead of 15 times 5, let's do 25 times 3. That's better because square root of 25?
5.
5. So there you go.
And then 3 and 3.
I think I got that wrong.
Well, among other things, 3 is prime, so it definitely is not going to break down anymore, let alone have factors that are square roots. Alright, so how to approach this? Here's one way that's already been discussed. Let's multiply 60 by 6.
360.
Okay, here, think about this. 60 definitely has a factor of 2 in it, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Definitely, so there's a little way to. 6 also has a factor of 2. When that 2 and the 6 and the 2 and the 60 multiply together, what do they make?
4.
A 4, so there's definitely like some square numbers to be had. I'm multiplying 60 by 6.
So 360, and then you 4 and 90. So. Thing.
Okay, so 360.
And then 4 and 90.
4 and 90. Why is 4 and 90 good?
It's because 4 is the smooth square root, but 90 is not.
Okay, so 4 has a square root of 2.
Yeah.
What about 90, though? Does 90 have any square factors?
It does, but they're not smooth.
No, not square roots. Factors that do have
30 times 3.
I'm hearing a lot of things. Let's look at 30 times 3. The question asked is, does 30 have a square root that's nice?
No.
Does 3 have a square root that's
no,
nice?
No.
So 30 times 3, though it is 90.
45 times 2.
Times 2.
But
does 45 have a square root that
no.
is nice?
No.
Does 2 have a square root
no.
that is nice?
No.
So then we don't like that one.
What's 15 times?
So who's got a factorization, I think? Clint?
What can I? I'm
working with 90. 15
times
6.
There's also.
Oh, 15 times 6. No. That won't work, dude.
The square root of 9 times 40. But I did square root of 36.
Wait.
Can you just
I'm
do
asking about the square root. 90. I'm asking if 90 can be factored in
some way.
Yes,
9
and
10.
9 times 10.
Does 9 have a square root? That's nice.
Yep,
3.
So that's 2 times, this is 3, right?
2 times
3
times
6.
10.
Times the square root of 10. So some of you went another route. We'll see now that
I did, like,
matched up.
I think I did 12 and 15. I don't know how I got that.
Like, oh, well, doesn't have a nice square root. I wonder how much all of this talking amongst ourselves is really helping us. Because I think not much.
I got that, but instead of doing the square root of 4 times 90, I did the square root of 36 times 10.
Please?
Hey, I have a question. So, number one, how do you know if the box around the 3 and not the 5?
Okay, hold on just a second. Let's
Couldn't
finish this
the
one out.
6 times the square root of 10 be simplified even more?
No.
This
no.
one?
It would be the same.
If it could, then we'd have to factor 10. Is 10 factorable?
Yeah, it's factorable.
Only has 5 times 2. Does 5 have a square root that's nice?
No.
Does 2 have a square root that's nice? So it could be factored, but it's when we do it, then it, nothing gets anything nicer, simpler, smaller, or anything like that. So even though it seems like we should be able to go farther, there's just no factor of 10 that will be able to take the square root up nicely. But the square root of 36 is 6 times the square root of 10. So we get the same answer, just
shorter.
Yeah, a little shorter. Like one step. To Clint's question, how do I know to have the square root around the 3 and not the 5? Who can answer that?
Oh.
For sure?
Because you couldn't factor 3 into any smooth square roots after, but for 25, you got 5 from that, so that's why you put it on the outside.
The answer is like, there's not an outside and an inside necessarily, right?
To the left.
It's, well, that doesn't matter. All I meant was that, it's not that I'm taking this 5 outside of anything, right? It's already, the square root of 25 is already not inside this square root, right? It's in its own square root. I'm not taking anything out of anything at all. I'm just saying, what's the square root of 25?
5.
It's 5. So I'm writing what the square root of 25 is. So there's no deciding what goes in and what goes out. I'm just taking the square root of a number, and I'm writing what the square root of that number is. 5 is the square root of 25. Does not, like, the square root symbol disappears, and I'm just evaluating the square root of a number. Just like for this one. It's not like I know this is going to be a 6 and this is going to be a 10, and I have to decide which one goes inside. I can take the square root of 36, it's the number 6. I cannot take the square root of 10 smoothly, it's just going to have to stay square root of 10. Okay? And the answer to, like, why is this number on the outside of a square root? It's just because it's the same as this number. It's just what the square root of 25 is, it's 5. This is just what the square root of 36 is, it's 6. Did that answer your question?
Yeah.
In what way did it not answer your question?
It is confusing, but I don't understand it all.
What's confusing about it?
Well, all this stuff.
What stuff?
Well, like, just what to do with those numbers. But I understand it better now.
Is there any way you can understand it better?
It's okay.
That's up to you.
Yeah.
The opportunity, now's the time. Anything you don't understand about this? Well, it's a new subject rather than like a day later on when I still don't quite fully understand it.
Okay, so like,
yes.
Go ahead. The 9, so don't you just, when you, it's 3, so you just take cube minus 3.
Yeah, because this number is 3, right? So the square root of 9 is 3, so what I'm multiplying 2 by is 3.
Okay.
That number is 3.
Why did you do the
okay. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So, I mean, I could have written another step in between where I put 2 and then times and the square root of 9 is 3, and the 3 there, and then the square root of 10, and then 2 times 3, which would be 6.
Okay.
Yeah.
Probably.
So do negative numbers not have square roots?
They do not have real square roots. They have imaginary square roots.
Imaginary?
Yeah, that'll be for later this year, so no worries right now.
So do you have to multiply the two square roots before you do anything else?
Well, in this case, yes. In this case, let me just make up another example. The square root of 27 times the square root of 2. Multiplying these together in this case is not going to help.
49,
the
yeah.
The reason why we needed to do it for this one, is what I said before we went too far, was that, look, this 6 does have a factor of 2, right? Yeah. Forget about the other factor that it has. Just concentrate on the fact that it has a factor of 2. Okay? And the 60 also has a factor of 2, right? Mm-hmm. So forget about all the other factors that 60 has. 60 inside here has a factor of 2. 6 has a factor of 2. When those 2's, when I multiply this all together, those two 2's are going to multiply together and make up 4. And 4 has a square root. And I wouldn't figure out that 4 existed until I multiplied the 6. So I wouldn't get everything that there is to get. But here, now 27 does not have a factor of 2. So this 2 is not going to multiply by anything to make a 4. Okay? To help us see what I'm talking about, this is what I wanted to bring up.
Question.
Yes, sorry, go ahead.
Alright, so I took, like, for 60, I took 4 and 15,
yes.
And I got 2, 15, and then...
Okay, so you took the square root of 4 times the square root of 15 times the square root of 6.
Well, see, that's the problem. I got 2, 15.
2 times the square root of 15.
And then I thought you times 6, times 6, times 2. And I put it 12 to the power of 15.
6 times 6 times 2.
I just times 6 times 2.
Oh, 6 12. Times 2. Mm-hmm. This is the 6 right here.
Yeah.
The problem is that 6, it's not really the number 6. This is the number 2. This is not the number 6. This is a number that multiplies by itself to give you 6.
Yeah, I know.
Right? And so
I said 12, but I didn't know it.
12 times the square root of 15. Yeah. That were just 6, like that was the square root of 36, and then that was actually worth 6, and 6 times 2 would be 12, 5. It's not the case, it's still inside. But what we could do is multiply, since these are both inside square roots, 15 times 6. Right? And so we get 2 times the square root of 15 times 6 is 90. And now we're right on this guy here. 2 root 90, back into 9 times 10, 6 square root of 9 is 3, 2 times 3 is 6, 6 root 10. To help us see how this is gonna break down, how this could be simplified, let's just look at all the factors. I mean, right here, the example of the square root of 4 times the square root of 90. I could write this as the square root of 4 times 90, right? All eyes up here, engaged, listening to the question. The question is, could I write this square root of 360 times this is the square root of inside the square root 4 times 90? Is that true?
No, yes.
Is 4 times 90 360?
Yeah.
Yes.
So this is still the square root of 360?
Yeah, but there's just multiple square roots that you can do.
Yeah, so I can do more square roots.
Just
now I can see here, right? I don't want to be too silly with this, but I could kind of that. It becomes 2 square roots, square root of 4 times square root of 90. So I can see just before I did that, just before that, when it was 4 times 90, that this is going to be a square root of 4, and the square root of 4 is going to be 2. Does that make sense? Huh? I think a 360 has 4 times 90. 360 has 4 times 90. I know that just after this, I could turn it into 2 square roots, square root of 4 times the square root of 90. See what I'm going with that?
Yep.
I see 360 is 4 times 90. I know that I can take the square root of 4 off by itself, take square root of 4 is 2, right? I can see the writing on the wall when I write it factored all together and get a square root. So let's do that with these 2 square roots here. So the square root of 60, let's factor it until it just can't be factored anymore and see all the factors that make up 60. And see if there's any factors that would go together to make a square number, a number that has a perfect square root.
4.
Okay, so it's 4 times something? It's 4 times 15?
Yeah.
Okay, it's the square root of 6. But the 4 can be factored.
Right, to 2.
That's 2 times 2. And the 15 can be factored.
3 times 5.
That's 3 times 5. And the 6 can be factored.
2 times 3.
2 times 3. If I multiply all of these factors together under one square root,
you get 3
it
would
look like 2 times 2 times
4.
2 times 3 times 3 times 5. Right? If I just like write them all from lowest to smallest to largest. There's got a 2 and another 2, so 2 times 2 times 2. And there's a 3 times 3 times there's another 3 times 5. That's usually how we write factorizations from smallest factor to largest. Mm-hmm. We all agree that to multiply 2 times 2 times 3 times 5 times 2 times 3 is the same as what I have written down here on the bottom.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
Exactly.
Oh.
Good stretch. Come on, okay. Now I could multiply these numbers together, or I could think a little bit ahead and say, don't I know that 2 times 2 is going to be what?
4.
And that so that 4 can come over and be separated and have its own square root, and the square of 4 would be what? So this, like these two twos, like we're going to avoid doing all of this, like multiplying and then unmultiplying. This 2 times 2 is going to make a 4, then I'm going to take the square root of 4, and the square root of 4 is going to be what?
2.
2. So these two twos together, when I take the square root of 2 times a 2, is going to be 2.
2.
See if that happens again. Look at this. Here's a 3 and a 3. Here's a 3 times a 3. So that's 9, but it's inside the square root, so we're going to take the square root of 9. And the square root of 9 is 3. No surprise, because how did we get 9? We multiplied a number by itself to get 9. That number was 3. So I know like this will become the square root of
2.
Square root of 4. Square root of 2 times 2. Times, if I wanted to write it in this order, times the square root of 2, times the square root of 9, times the square root of 5.
And that's just to get the 360.
Well, if I multiply those together, I would get 360, but that's not the goal we have. The goal we have is simplifying this expression. And so 4 has a nice square root. 9 has a nice square root. 2 does not. 5 does not. See what I'm trying to show you? I'm showing you that if we look at all the prime factors, we can look at the factors that are going to go together to make numbers that have square roots. These two 2s are going to go together to make numbers that have square roots. These two 3s are going to go together to make a number that has a square root. Okay?
That'd be 2 times 2 times 2.
So what would you do with the leftovers?
Okay, so we've got, maybe we could pull these together. Square root of 4 times the square root of 9 times the square root of 2 times the square root of 5. Okay, so 4, square root of that is 2, square root of 9 is 3. 2 does not have a square root, 5 does not have a square root. Okay, and it's not like any multiplying goes together is going to give us any number that has a square root. We had it all factored out to its prime factorization. Okay. 2 times 5 is not going to make a square number. 2 times 2 makes a square number, 3 times 3 makes a square number, 4 times 4 makes a square number. A number times itself makes a square number. 2 times 5 is not going to do it. I found a pair of 2s, square of that's going to be 2. Found a pair of 3s, that's going to be a 3. Any pair of numbers that we find is just going to make a number where the square root is that number. So the leftover square root 2, square root of 5, multiply together gives us square root of 10. 2 times 3 is 6. Again, 6 root 10.
Logical reason.
So you can keep like factoring it like that. You can just factor it all the way down and look at pairs of factors that can go together to make square numbers anyway. Just
hold on.
Any way that makes sense to you. Somehow I have a strategy for finding the largest square number that goes into 360. Keep going. Did great. Perfect. No reason to change it. If you just keep breaking it down and breaking it down until you're left with something inside the square root that doesn't break down anymore, that works as well. Just make sure you don't stop here at 2 root 90, because 90 can be broken down. If you like this, if you just want to factor all of the factors until there's no more prime factors left, and look for pairs of numbers, a pair of 2s will have a square root of 2, a pair of 3s will have a square root of 3. That way as well. Okay, so we don't need to get our cards or anything. What do you think? 81, the number 81 minus 25 is 56. There's no debate about that. 81 minus 25 is 56. But is the square root of 81 minus the square root of 25 equal to the square root of 56?
Nope. No.
What's that?
Nine.
That'd be 9 and that'd be 5.
Okay.
It's not the square root of 56? How do you know
but
it's
not the
square root of 56?
But what if you could do 4 of 56? What's the square root of 56? I know it's not 6.
What's that? 4 times 4 is 16. It's not 56. So there is a definite nail in the coffin for is 4 the square root of 56. No, it's the square root of 16. So, does this work?
Yeah. What's 56 divided by 4?
Yeah. Does it matter?
I don't know. Just exploring.
Well,
14.
If this were to be true, then this would have to be the square root of 56. So it doesn't really matter what we can look at it. But.
Okay.
There might be something more, but there's. Well, in my knowledge, there's not. So taking 81 minus 25 and saying this is the square root of 56, no. Also, another way to convince somebody from this class maybe that this wouldn't be true. Didn't I ask a question that was similar to this yesterday?
Yeah.
Yes.
Similar,
yes,
but different. Addition instead of subtraction.
Right.
Did the addition of two square roots work?
No.
No.
Oh, can we try division?
You can do the division one and the division
addition
one
and subtraction. Addition and subtraction are very similar. They're like two sides of the same coin. Subtraction is just addition of negative numbers, right? But
well, multiplication and division are pretty similar.
Right.
And the division one didn't work, so.
You tried it already?
Division.
Yeah, we did it yesterday.
We did.
Yeah.
Anything
we
I just
did.
Said,
no.
Try
division
it out, and investigate.
We
here, let's
did,
try this one.
Oh wait, that was something else.
Okay
never mind.
Let's try square root of 64 over the square root of 4.
8 over 2.
Is that the square root of what's 64 divided by 4?
8, 12, 16.
So, instead of talking over each other, please, what to do with you? Square is 64 over the square root of 4. The question is, can I just take them under the same square root, divide 64 by 4, and call it the square root of 16?
No.
Yes or no, and why? Division being so similar to multiplication, like in the same family, then probably it would work too. And it turns out that it does work. If I take the square root of x and the square root of y, I could write that as the square root of what?
X divided by y.
So we have that. We would take more time to practice.